Previously on Kalahari Meerkats.
Delilah's first litter of pups are dead. We're not sure if Claire killed them herself, or whether she indirectly sealed their fate when she instigated a burrow move just after they were born. What we do know is that Iron Lady Cleo is not open to any other female having pups in her gang. Delilah is seeking revenge by splitting the group and reducing the gosa gang to only 7 members. And as if things couldn't get worse, Cleo was badly bitten when trying to mob a deadly Cape Cobra. Is the support of her close-knit family enough to pull her through? Let's rejoin the gosa gang of meerkats. This is Cleopatra, known as Cleo, the alpha female and leader of the group. Gandalf is her partner and the wise protector of the gang. Delilah is Cleo's sister and might well be planning a coup to become the leader herself. Napoleon, the lazy one, doing as little as possible. Solo, allowed back in the fold and not alone anymore. And the 4 mischievous meerkat kids. Starsky and his naughty brother Hutch. And Priscilla and Matimba, the caring sisters. When you're only 12 inches tall, the Kalahari is a vast and dangerous place to live. But this 11-strong group of meerkats call it home. They manage to scratch out a living in a 3-square-mile territory. What makes these little fellas special is their lives are followed and documented by wildlife filmmaker Rob Brains.
After more than 6 months of filming, we're slowly beginning to understand their family lives. I have witnessed attacks by predators, fights with other gangs, and even internal splits. There is always something happening.
It is winter in the Kalahari, and although the desert is green, it is very dry, and the rains will not return for a good few months. As a result, food is becoming more scarce, and rival gangs of meerkats are having to live back to back vying for dwindling resources. The gosa gang are living in between 2 much bigger groups of meerkats. Yako's June to the south, and the rock stars to the north. This is not a great position to be in, and times are tough for our gang. To make things worse, their leader, Cleo, has been injured by a Cape Cobra and is fighting for her life. This deadly creature produces a neurotoxin that shuts down the respiratory system. Meerkats do have a high resistance to its venom, but have also been known to die within 24 hours of a Cape Cobra bite. The gossas seem unsettled and nervous. The alpha female holds the group together, and with her fighting for her life in the burrow, they feel insecure. At least Delilah and her splinter group have rejoined the rest of the family to bolster their numbers somewhat. Delilah was traumatized after Cleo killed her pups and set out to rival the gossas with a new gang. She wanted to be queen and had had enough of being submissive to her sister. Birds of prey are constantly looking for an opportunity to take a meerkat, and a group without enough sentries would be easy pickings.
I think that Delilah realized she may have a high chance of being queen of the gossas due to Cleo's potentially fatal injury. It was an opportunity that she certainly wasn't going to miss.
It's a beautiful morning here in the Kalahari, and the gang are getting on with the task of tidying their home. In the distance, there's a lone meerkat. It seems to be a roving male from another gang. Roving is a risky business, as males from other groups will often fight and kill any wandering males. This male is looking to mate, and has obviously crossed the border from the Yakos June group to the south. It's a perfect time to mate, as when the rains come, food will be plentiful and the pups will thrive. As the sly male gets closer, Gandalf is on high alert. With Cleo injured, Gandalf is not allowing anyone into his game. This male is unlucky this time, but there will be many more coming to try their luck.
This little incident has put Gandalf even more on edge. I've never seen him like this. I think he prefers to be the protector, but not the leader. I really hope Cleo gets better. Otherwise, this gang is in for a rough winter.
The group head out to forage. It's past breakfast time and they are starving. A meerkat can shift more than its own body weight in sand, and right now this is necessary. The wholesome snacks are few and far between, and most of them are hidden deep. Priscilla has always been a great digger, and today her skills have paid off. She has a beetle. Only one problem, it's poisonous. Meerkats may be immune to this poison, as they share an ancestry with the mongoose. This is not certain, but judging by Priscilla's excitement at winning this delectable meal, they are certainly not scared. Brutus has other things on his mind this morning. He is desperate to mate with one of the females in the group. He has been spurned by Delilah, and Cleo is injured, so he sets his sights on the vulnerable Solo. Before he can seal the deal, Gandalf is there to lay down the law. Whilst Cleo is not around, he is the leader. He cannot have Brutus mating with his females, not while he is the alpha. He needs to keep Brutus submissive. Brutus is tired of having to accept defeat and wants to find an alternative. He knows that he has to put up with this type of treatment while he is in the gosa gang. But what if he tries to find females elsewhere?
To be honest, I think Brutus would be mad to leave the group. Roving males put themselves in danger constantly. It is much safer to have the security of the group. I guess a man has to do what a man has to do.
Brutus is heading in the direction of the gosa gang's rivals, the rock stars. Back at the burrow, there is a great surprise. Cleo has appeared from the burrow. 2 days of darkness has left her dazed by the sunlight, and she looks like she has lost weight. She is, however, alive, and there is no sign of any permanent injury.
I am so relieved to see Cleo. It's great to have her back. The gossas will be much stronger with her around. Gandalf already seems so much more relaxed. He is enjoying grooming her and strengthening the bond that these two have. I think he missed her. The kids are also happy to have Cleo back and play excitedly.
But this lady is one hungry meerkat. Having not eaten for 2 days, her body is weak and she needs food more than ever. Times are tough for Cleo, but this iron lady gets to work digging for tasty treasure. She's in luck, a frog. This is a rare find, but will give her the energy she needs. Frogs are amphibians, and it is unusual to find them this far from water. She struggles to chew and digest this large meal. Frogs are not often on the meerkat menu. Cleo also needs to keep an eye on Delilah. She has a history of vying for the leadership role. Cleo managed to get rid of her pups, but what if Delilah got pregnant again whilst Cleo was in this weakened state? In fact, she needs to keep all of her females in check. They are back at the burrow, and Solo has turned up late and missed out on doing any chores. She knows that Cleo is angry. Solo's late arrival has not been missed. Cleo is biting her, and this is a painful reminder that her leader is angry. Having been expelled from the gang before, Solo is particularly vulnerable to another eviction and starts to tidy house frantically. It's late afternoon, and Brutus is still trying to find the rock stars. He knows if he can subtly edge his way into their territory, he may be able to have a quick liaison with one of their females. As the afternoon draws on, he comes across a lone female.
I'm not sure if she has been evicted by one of the two rival gangs that border the gosa territory, or if she has come from somewhere else. Her ragged appearance is a sign that she has been on her own for a while.
Meerkats that get evicted from a group can survive for up to a year or longer, depending on food availability. Maybe this female had become pregnant and she had been evicted by her alpha female. It has been shown that eviction doubles the probability for an abortion if the evicted female was pregnant, and it results in a severely impaired ability of the evicted female to successfully conceive. She welcomes the attention she receives from Brutus. Brutus and the lone female spent a romantic night together in a disused burrow, and Brutus is first up. It's a beautiful Kalahari winter's morning, and Brutus is off. His night with the female was very welcome, but he must carry on in his mission to get to the rock stars. Unfortunately, the lone female is left to a life of solitude. The chances that a single female makes her way into an established healthy group are minimal. She will need to look out for any new groups forming, as this would be her only chance to be invited in. Finally, Brutus can see the rock stars, led by the dominant female. Luckily, there is no sign of the alpha male. He hangs around on the periphery and tries to get the ladies to see him.
It is unclear to me whether Brutus is trying to join this group permanently or whether he just wants a quick liaison with one of the females. There have been cases where an unrelated male was allowed into a group and stayed subordinate, and maybe this is what Brutus wants.
Suddenly, Brutus has been noticed, but unfortunately for him, not just by the ladies. The guys in the group have also caught wind and are not too happy. They immediately try to intimidate or scare off the unwelcome Brutus. The closest male climbs a bush to try and keep an eye on him. Brutus is very inexperienced with this kind of flirting, and in his eagerness, he has got far too close. Some of the males give chase. Brutus has a lucky escape. He's learnt his lesson and heads back to the safety of the gosa gang. The gossas are up early and are sunning their tiny bodies in the morning sun. The meerkat has a relatively bare patch of black skin on its belly, otherwise known as the stomach solar panel. It exposes this patch to the sun in order to absorb heat and warm up. All 11 meerkats are together again, and there is a sense of relaxation in the family.
Cleo is looking much stronger. Gandalf has not left her side since she reappeared. He knows how important it is to nurse her back to health, and I think he secretly loves having this important role.
He also keeps an eye out for predators, but with only a distant vulture in sight, he can get on with his other business. He has first mating rights with Cleo, and needs to keep the other males in check. Napoleon is too lazy to even be bothered with trying to mate with Cleo, and his brother Dingon has too much respect. But their brother Brutus is the one that Gandalf feels most threatened by, as he has been frisky for a while. Today, however, Brutus is happy to be back in the safety of the group, and heads up sentry duty in order to get back into Gandalf's good books. The kids are having a game of cat and mouse with a ground squirrel. Meerkats live peacefully with Cape ground squirrels and often share their sleeping burrows with them, although this is not a permanent arrangement. Suddenly, Brutus makes an alarm call from the tree.
They have many cheetah on this reserve, and they are the only cat that would be awake at this time. I think it is them that are alerting the gang. The gossas pile into the tree to see what's going on. Gandalf and Cleo are seriously high up. They must have a good view from there. The two cheetah brothers are only 200 meters from us. Just their presence is creating panic.
The Kalahari grassland lends itself to the cheetah lifestyle. Males are often social and may group together for life, usually with their brothers of the same litter. They have managed to find some water to drink from.
This many meerkats on one branch was obviously going to end in disaster. Poor old Matimba, taken out by the mischievous Starsky.
After an exciting morning at the burrow, they eventually head out to forage. Because of the cheetah excitement, they are late and bellies are rumbling. It is midwinter here, and at this time of year, a good meal is hard to come by. They need to spread out far and wide so that all of them can get enough food. Delilah succeeds first with a delicious lizard. Lizards are a perfect size for a meerkat and have no venom, which makes it an easy snack. The rest of the family are expending so much effort digging in the dry sand, but wholesome snacks are few and far between. Even Napoleon is putting in effort. His belly is rumbling, and he recognizes the fact that no one else is going to help him, like usual. He is rewarded with a worm. Worms are not the most nutritious meal you find here in the Kalahari, but for Napoleon, it is a great achievement. Starsky and Hutch are the youngest and most inexperienced foragers, and they are really suffering from the late start. They start to wander far from the group in the direction of the Gosa Dam, which is now Yucco's dune territory. This large group of meerkats are the main rivals of the Gosa gang, and recently took over the Gosa Dam burrow. This prime piece of real estate is most sought after, but unfortunately, the Gosa gang don't have the strength in numbers they need. Starsky and Hutch must be extra vigilant as they enter this new territory. But for now, it seems to be paying off. The venom from this scorpion is having no effect on Starsky, and such a large meal will keep him happy for a while. Raiding someone's pantry is risky, and it's only a matter of time before Yucco's June realize that their larder is being depleted. Starsky and Hutch suddenly figure out that they are lost inside Yucco's June territory and need to be extra vigilant to avoid being detected.
Although we are in early winter, temperatures still soar at midday here in the Kalahari. The gossers are taking a midday nap in a bolt hole, and so I'm going to do the same. Suddenly, siesta is over. Their frantic movements roused even me from being fast asleep. It seems that they have realized that Starsky and Hutch have gone missing during the afternoon break.
If they get caught in Yucco's June territory, eating their food, then it could be fatal for them. Cleo is beside herself, and Gandalf has scampered up a tree to see if he can get any idea of where the two delinquents may be. It has been decided that Gandalf will head out to find them and try and save their lives, whilst Cleo will stay at home and keep the gang together. Starsky and Hutch have been caught trespassing and are now frantically trying to find their way home, with part of the Yucco's June group hot on their tails. As they flee, they realize that now they are literally running for their lives. All they want now is the comfort of the Gosa gang, and particularly Mum and Dad. As they run and run, they see another group in the distance. Not having any idea of where they are or how far they have run, they are not sure if these meerkats are their family or another rival gang. With Yucco's June hot in pursuit, they have to chance it and hope for the best. The relief when they realize that it is indeed their own family is huge. Mutual bonding between them and the others is what's planned for the rest of the afternoon.
I only now realize that Gandalf is still missing. He is an adult, so it is not worth worrying as he can look after himself, but I set out to find him anyway. Coming across the springbok carcass made me realize how dangerous the bush can be.
This young buck has been killed by a leopard that lives in this territory. It is not unusual for a leopard to kill its prey and leave it in a tree so nothing can get it. It will return later to finish the meal. Gandalf needs to return to the family soon, or he too could face a leopard looking for food.
I managed to catch up with Gandalf on the periphery of the Yaku's Dune territory. Yaku's Dune has split into two groups, and Gandalf was close to a group with most of the females and pups. They seem edgy and nervous about Gandalf's presence and try to intimidate him. Not seeing Starsky and Hutch, he carries on searching. Suddenly, something spooked the females, and as they dart off, one of their pups gets left behind. What happened next was something I have never seen before. Gandalf is submissive towards the pup and seems to want to bond with it.
By now, Gandalf is starting to feel stressed by the unproductiveness of his mission. The afternoon is drawing on and he is not sure where he is. He needs to find the kids, but also does not want to spend a night on his own. It's difficult for him to find food and keep an eye out for predators at the same time, without the protection of the rest of the gang. With a stroke of luck, he manages to kill a tiger snake to provide a larger than normal energy boost. The tiger snake is a small, slow-moving snake that is only really alert at night. They like to raid the huge nests of the weaver birds and kill the chicks. But this snake is no match for Gandalf, who makes quick work of it. It gives him the energy to carry on and find his family. The gosa foraging party are heading home. Temperatures are dropping fast, and there may even be a storm coming. The best thing is to get to the safety of the burrow, where they will be warm and cozy together. Still on his own, in a bolt hole far from the gang, Gandalf struggles to keep warm. This morning is freezing, and Gandalf has had one of the worst nights of his life. He is freezing. All his energy has been taken up trying to keep himself warm during the long night, and now he still has to find his way home. Gandalf is very vulnerable. As a meerkat on your own, you do not have a sentry team to protect you whilst you are foraging. He is in grave danger. At the dam, the Yakko's Dune gang is enjoying the sight of a pair of Egyptian geese flying above their heads. It is a peaceful morning. Suddenly, their leader has everyone on alert. Their rivals, the gosa gang, are approaching at fast speed. Cleo has only one thing on her mind, and that is getting this prime piece of real estate back for her family. Yakko's initially stand their ground, but soon they realize that Cleo is serious. Our gang are covering ground at lightning speed, and this time it is Yakko's Dune's turn to turn tail. Cleo doesn't stop until she is sure that every meerkat from this rival gang is gone. After a quick inspection, she decides it is now safe. They have succeeded and it is now time to relax and celebrate. While some of them start to groom, others simply enjoy the view that they have missed. But poor old Gandalf is still lost and freezing cold. He has no idea whether he will ever see his family again, and is surrounded by predators. Is this the end for Gandalf?